What's up, guys? So I am wearing my Slytherin top today, which means we're going to talk about Harry Potter, right? Yeah. Oh, boy. This is an instance where I actually find myself, for the most part, pretty well on the side of my fellow trans community. It's like, well, Nicole, you should be on the side of the trans community in general. You're trans, so therefore, why would you... Hang on. The issue that I've had is, this is similar to a lot of people. I mean, very obviously, I don't think anybody should buy the game because, well, you are giving, you know, J.K. Rowling the money. More to the point, you're giving the developers the money who are themselves already kind of, you know, some of them, especially the executives at least, they are rich assholes and they don't deserve it. But some of them are also transphobic. Some of them are problematic. Not only that, the very concept of the fact that there is a trans character called Sir Rona Ryan, and then also the fact that, you know, the last letters of the name spell out Aryan. I don't know if that's relevant or not, but just kind of an interesting thought. We're just kind of picking fun at the name now. But as some trans people have described it, and I would agree, the most clockiest fucking trans person that they could have developed. So, I mean, this is very much intentional. I don't know how much of the name was pondered over that well, and even if they even took, you know, gave it a second thought. You know, maybe the name itself wasn't even the issue. It's the issue that you decided to include a trans character that, you know, for all intents and purposes, I guess A for effort. But the problem is that given the already problematic nature of J.K. Rowling and the very sensitive issue of trans people that we're talking about, yeah, you, at that point, you might as well have not made the character to begin with. At this point, I'd rather you just call me a slur. But yeah, no, that was part of it. But more to the point, you shouldn't buy the game just on principle itself, just because of the trans principle. But you also shouldn't buy the game because it's a shitty fucking game. By the way, that Professor What's-His-Name character, the new one, he dies at the end. You're welcome. I just saved you money, time, and an awkward conversation with your trans friends. It's a shitty game. I was already watching the development process of this game, and number one, it feels like we didn't really get anything for a long time about this game, and it felt in a lot of ways like they kind of rushed it through just a little bit at the end. So I think it's going to be kind of like a Bethesda game or even a Rockstar game where it's like, you know, or just any corporate made game where basically it's going to be, you know, you're under pressure, you have a time constraint, and you need to get this out. Okay, I get that. That's kind of how I treat my videos. Especially, right, you know, these days. But the point that I'm trying to make is the game just sucks. The gameplay itself, from what I've understood for some people, is glitchy. It's not very well thought out or made, and it's kind of lacking from the previous Harry Potter game that was made, which was, I think, the... What was it? The I don't remember. I think it was like Hogwarts Mystery or some shit. But the point is that it fell way short of a lot of people's expectations. And people I but more to the point, people still keep saying, "Oh, well, I want to still try it out. I want to see it for myself." And normally I would agree with you, but drawing back to the whole trans issue thing, it's best that you don't. But I'm also going to completely contradict myself in a way, because I'm also going to talk about how boycotting doesn't work. But we'll get to that in just a wee bit. What I wanted to talk about was the issue that, yeah, you shouldn't buy it because, again, you're essentially giving money to transphobic people. More to the point, you're giving fuel to a already fascistic idealism that exists amongst J.K. Rowling and her like-minded, groups of, trans exclusionary reactionary fascists. Terse. Because I refuse to call them radical, trans exclusionary radical feminists, because they're not radical and they're not feminists. They're reactionary and they're fascists. They don't even uphold the idea of feminism. The idea of feminism is, well, egalitarianism, gender egalitarianism, and that includes everybody, not just cis people. Unless you're a pat sock and then you agree with them, but pat socks are just, fucking fascists anyway. But yeah, no, you shouldn't buy the game just on the principle of frickin', you shouldn't buy it on principle just because of the fact that you're basically giving money to this idealism that, because, okay. Let me basically explain this to people. When you buy this game and your money is going to the developers, etc., like, most people are right in one sense. J.K. Rowling has already gotten her money. They already cut her the check the minute they were like, "Okay, the game development's been approved." They already cut her the fucking check. So, she's gonna get that money regardless. They're trying to essentially return, the money that they spent on the game, plus obviously make a profit, because that's how capitalism works. And essentially, they're making money, profiting off of this game, but more to the point, they're profiting off of a already problematic franchise because of its creator. Now, I personally believe that we can separate the art from the artist. And yes, there's people that are going to bring up the argument of the anti-Semitism and blah, blah, blah. Okay. You know what? That's something we can discuss in the comments, on Twitter, or in a separate video. And by all means, it's not that I'm denying that there isn't problems within that. I'm just saying, let people who are fans of the series still be fans. And by the way, the people that also are like, "Well, I don't think I should be bullied, I should be able to continue to enjoy it." You can. Just don't give her the money. Don't go buying stuff directly through like Pottermore or any sort of like thing like that. Even going to Hot Topic and buying something, and believe me, this is hard for me, but going to Hot Topic and buying, say, the newest Harry Potter skirt or dress or whatever it is, that's still the merch. It's still brand name merch, and that money is still going to her. I mean, yes, some of it's going to the makers of the garment, but it's some of it still trickles its way up to Joanne. And that's the point I'm trying to make. That's why I tell people, you can still be a fan. You can still wear your shirts, your dresses, etc. God knows I do. I still do it, and I do it very publicly. And have the awkward conversations to go along with it. But the difference is, I get my stuff off of like Etsy, Poshmark, etc. I use third-party resources. I buy these things second, third, fourth, hundredth, you know, yeah. I basically buy it offhand. And but for God's sake, I know that it comes with its own risks and its own glitches and its own fucking problems in itself, but if you really, really must engage in the nostalgia, which I'm totally for, if you want to engage in the nostalgia, I'm all here for. We all who actually are big time fans should still indulge in it. But if you're going to buy the game, pirate it instead of actually like buying, instead of buying it, you know, buy it, pirate it, get it from some sort of third party resource. And like I said, that comes with its own risks, and, you know, be careful on what you click on, be careful who you give your information to, but still, pirate it. But don't buy it directly from the game makers. Don't buy your merch from, you know, directly through a lot of these, you know, outlets. Buy it online through Etsy or Poshmark and through somebody who they themselves have, you know, already, you know, done that. And it's like, yeah, they've already spent their money, and yeah, that comes with its own probably system of problems and stuff like that, but you know what? At least your money is not going to Joanne. Now that I've kind of explained that rub, this is where I'm getting at to this point. You can do all of that I just said, but here's the problem that I have with the people that are saying who are just in general saying, boycott it, just don't buy it, don't do this, don't do that, burn your fucking merch, burn your books, burn. Why? You already obviously spent the money, or somebody did, whether it was your mom, your dad, your grandma, your sister, your aunt, I don't give a shit. Somebody already gave the money to somebody, and that has trickled down to Joanne somehow. Damage is done, whatever. Count your losses, move on. What good comes out of burning the books? What good comes out of burning your clothes? What good comes out of, you know, burning your DVDs? Okay, you can get rid of them. You know, yeah, you could sell them to people, whatever, get your money back. Okay, that's your prerogative. But to boycott, you know, just to outright boycott everything and be like, you know, oh, well, you shouldn't like Harry Potter because blah, 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 blah. No, because then you're fan shaming and you're basically telling people to stop liking something that they've been a fan of, you know, and may have in some cases really gotten them through a dark time in their life. So it might be kind of close to them, and you don't know what damage that does for them to, you know, and all this talk of, well, find something else. Well, it's not that simple for some people. And again, for some people, you know, this world and stuff like that, it's a security blanket. And yes, they can find something else. They can indulge in a different fandom. But, you know, sometimes that doesn't just come at the snap of a finger. You know, it's not magic, so to speak. I'm sorry. I had to make a stupid little joke. But what I'm saying is, it doesn't just happen. For some people, this is part of them, and it's been part of them for a bulk of their lives, or gotten them through a point in their life that wasn't so chipper. I can definitely understand that. I've been there. But yeah, so, but more to the point, boycotting doesn't do anything. It doesn't actually, like, at the end of the day, people are still going to buy the game. People are still going to give her merch, and it's unfortunate, and it's problematic. It is horrible, and it's saddening. But at the end of the day, the problem that really comes down to it is she already had the check cut to her, so it doesn't really matter. You're not really doing anything to oppose her. You're not getting rid of the system that she's benefiting off of, that she's exploiting people and benefiting off of. You're not challenging the people like her that are in power. What I'm getting at, and this is where the Marxist principle comes in, because, oh boy, Nicole, you're off on your little Marxist principle tangent again. Yeah, I'm a Marxist, you know, and if you obviously haven't seen the hammer and the sickle in the background and didn't turn off, well, that's your problem. The issue definitely is that boycotting doesn't work. It's a liberal concept, a liberal ideal, if you will, that doesn't mean anything. It's hollow, and it doesn't achieve anything. The only way that you're going to achieve trans liberation and get rid of these transphobic people and essentially threaten their wealth and power is to remove essentially the system that they benefit off of. And that's not going to come from holding up a picket sign, you know, or boycotting a game. That's only going to come from direct action. Armed direct action. Well, I don't like guns, and I think... Well, then you're part of the problem then, ain't you? That's it. Cut and dry. That's how you're going to do it. And if you think that boycotting actually somehow works, oh, then you're just a naive little snowflake, aren't you? Oh, boy. Yeah, no, it's just... You're not going to achieve anything because boycotting does nothing. It doesn't. I'm sorry, it doesn't. So, you know, yeah, tell people not to buy the game, which is, in all aspects... You know, yeah, they shouldn't. In fact, they should probably pirate it if they want it so bad. And by all means, I support that idea of them pirating it. I would much rather them pirate it and play the game than actually buy it outright. But the people that think that they shouldn't play the game at all because of how problematic it is and how problematic, you know, J.K. Rowling is, well, that's not realistic, and it's kind of a dumb concept. Like, really, it doesn't do anything. It's not challenging her, it's not challenging her wealth. It's not challenging the people like her in power. So, at the end of the day, maybe consider the alternatives here. Maybe consider this perspective, because at the end of the day... You know, the only way you're going to truly go after them, that truly bring them down, is through direct force, direct armed resistance, revolution. I'm Red Pagan Nicole, and this has been Red Pagan Corner. Till next time.